you're just joining us, good morning. Here are the 8 things you need to know today. Utility crews from Central Maine Power are heading down to Pennsylvania today to help out after yesterday's ice storm there. CMP says it's sending 25 two-man line crews along with support personnel and equipment. You may remember utility crews from Pennsylvania came to Maine to help out after December's ice storm. Police say they've caught the man who robbed two credit unions in Lewiston. They say this man, 30-year-old Brent Roax, robbed the Rainbow Federal Credit Union Tuesday afternoon. He's also charged with last Friday's robbery at the Community Credit Union on Pine Street. We're expected to learn more about the state of the economy when we get the January jobs report tomorrow, but this report is getting some extra attention amid worries about the stock markets. However, experts say the numbers may be distorted by recent bad weather and the government's decision to end unemployment benefits in December. CVS announcing it will stop selling tobacco products come October. The company says it wants to support the health and well-being of its customers. The company is also launching a program in the spring that will provide resources to help smokers try and kick the habit.
And continuing the 8 things that you need to know today, the Department of Homeland Security has issued a warning about toothpaste bombs on flights to Russia. They say terrorists may try to hide explosives and tubes of toothpaste and then assemble the bombs on the plane or on the ground. But they say there is no direct threat to the United States. Subway has announced it is dropping the plastic from its fresh baked bread. The chain says it's responding to a petition signed by thousands of people to remove a chemical used in things like yoga mats and rubber, apparently bread dough as well. Well, good news for you Android fans out there. The New York Times saying Samsung's Galaxy S5 will likely be unveiled later on this month. It is expected to have a faster processor and an improved camera. And finally, if you want an iPad beginning today, Walmart is offering deep discounts on their tablets. The retailer is cutting the price of the iPad 2 by $100 for the next month. The store is also offering you cash back if you trade in your old iPad.